Plastic is something that we have made.
Plastics is both the finest and the worst expression of humankind.
The promise of plastic has always been that we can mold, make, or create anything we can envision.
This is the first synthetic compound created by man, a phenolic resin, the beginnings of the fourth kingdom on Earth. This is the world's first synthetic material, bakelite, the very first plastic.
A new documentary shares the story of the eccentric and brilliant Belgian chemist known as the father of the plastics industry, who forever changed the world with his invention in 1907. Joining us now, the film's executive producer, Hugh Carriker, and director, John Marr. Good morning.
Good morning.
Hey, I wanted to start with Hugh because this is the story of your grandfather, Leo Bakeland. Tell me, why did you guys want to tell this story?
It's my great-grandfather.
Great-grandfather.
My mother's grandfather.
And why did you want to tell his story?
She wanted to write a biography about him and passed away and left me all his papers and diaries. So I decided to make the movie.
And John, tell us about how the movie is organized. Do you just start from the beginning and then go to all the different forms that plastic has taken over the years?
Well, it's kind of like plastic itself. It's kind of a fluid film. It jumps around a bit. There's a little bit of humor in there. And we like to think there's a surprise around every corner.
And so give us a little tease, the surprise around every corner. We're looking at some video from the film right here. It looks like a lot of things we use everyday life and also sort of some artsy molds. And I'm not sure what that red rotating thing is. And obviously
a bracelet.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, we didn't shy away from the big problem with plastic today, which mm-hmm. is misuse. We definitely address that in the film, but we have some musical numbers in there. We hooked up with an outfit in Austin, Texas, Esther's Follies. There's kind of almost like a second city troupe down there. And mm-hmm. We did three little music videos that are within the film.
Why do you think Bakelite was so influential?
Do you want to cover that?
Well, at the time he invented it, automobiles, electricity, airplanes were becoming useful. And they needed a material that wouldn't conduct electricity, wouldn't dissolve. And my great-grandfather came up with the solution.
And Hugh, did you have access directly to these family archives? Was anything passed down to you over the generations?
Oh, yes. I have files of stuff, but most of it is at the Smithsonian now.
What do you guys hope? Go ahead, John.
We also have some of the original glassware, some of the original Erlenmeyer flasks and lab equipment that was actually used to create the first plastic or discover the first plastic bakelite. And we have a laboratory scene in the film, and we actually were able to use the original glassware that Leo Bakeland used in 1905, 1906, in that time period to create bakelite.
What are you hoping that people take away from this documentary, guys?
100 years ago, we solved problems with bakelite. Now, 100 years later, I hope we find solutions to the problems of today. And I hope this movie inspires innovators, chemists, designers, to come up with solutions to today's problems. Hmm.
John, what is your role in putting this together? I imagine that you interviewed many experts in this industry.
Yeah, we started out, you and I met each other on another film. We lived in the same town in Connecticut, and we did what we call the Dance of the Tarantulas, which is when you're starting out in a new venture, you need to get used to the people you're going to work with. Are they honorable, dependable? is it a good personality fit? And we discovered I actually needed some dancers for a scene, and you and his wife Sherry are terrific dancers. Yeah. And I danced the Lindy on a project that I was doing, and then after that he invited me to start working on the Bakelite film. And it's kind of like rock climbing in the sense that, for at least for me, you try to find a foothold somewhere in the story, interview maybe one or two people, which we did, and then you learn from that and you're able to pull yourself up a little further in the perspective of the film, and it leads you to the next interview or the next little film clip or whatever. And we basically pieced it together. I have a terrific team that I've worked with, I hate to say 35 years, but Craig Mkhitaryan as editor and Martin Fiji as composer, all the music is original. So we have a terrific team that helps put this together. But it was a long process that, you know, we went through a lot of iterations before we came up with what is now out there, All Things Bakelite.
All right. Well, Hugh and John, we really appreciate you telling us about this film. Looking forward to seeing it.
All right. For more, check out allthingsbakelite.com. You can also find them on Twitter and Facebook.
Thanks again.